Devshi from IntelliRise. So guys, till now we have created the database and also integrate it with API. Now we learn that how to create this API for getting the response from the for retrieving the values from the database table. So we'll go to the controller and we'll be adding one controller from here, and the name of controller, whatever you want to put, and let's say I'm doing it manage, and we'll add this controller. And now in this controller we'll create one function, public string, and the name, let's say get record. And then we'll write here the parameters which we'll pass through the Windows Store application. First name, let's say. After that, as we are interacting with database, so we'll do this by the models folder by adding one class from here, and the class name, let's say services, and we'll add this class. This class will interact with database and this will return the value to the controller, and that controller will take the values to the Windows Store application. This is the process. We'll again make a function here, public string, and let's say record rec. The name is the function, and we'll create one object here of the record type. Record obj. Record is the table name which we have created in the last video. Now after that we'll interacting with the UI. So we'll write a database. So we'll write here using, this is the link you query which we are using task entities. The connection string name, using task entities. One more thing which we have to add in the manage controller, that we are accessing the models folder. So we have to write here using app dynamic.models. Okay, all right. In this, we'll write here using test entities. Test entities was the name. Test entities DB context is equals to new test entities. After that, we'll write. We'll retrieve the values from the DB. So we'll write here DB context dot table name records dot where the name, we'll make one variable, declare dynamic variable I dot first name, means this I will be pointing to the table, and then we'll also take it first name here. If this becomes equals to the first name which we'll be sending through our application. If this become equal, then we'll select the whole query and we'll retrieve an object. Let's say obj is that object, and we'll declare the object here. Record type obj is equals to new record. So this query will select the table content if the first name become equal, and we'll store in this obj. Now we have to return some value, as this is a return, we have return type string, so we'll return the obj. So we have to also change the string from to record, and we'll return here. Return obj. Now again back to the controller, we'll access the services. So we'll make the service object for the services. Model is equals to new services. After that, we'll pass this first name in, we'll call that function which we have made in the services. So we'll write here model dot function name, that is rec, and we'll pass this first name, and we'll retrieve that obj which we are returning from here. Obj, and we are using obj, so we have to make the object also. Record obj is equals to new record. Alright. So this will be let's store in some. So now we have to also make one class for this. As for generating the class, we have to declare four variables. So we'll be adding one more class in this models folder, and then let the class name is response, and we'll add this. In this, first of all, let's make the response type is T. Now in this class, we'll declare the four variables: public, int for error, and public string. After that, public bool for send, true or false. After that, public string for message, and then public t for result. Now we create a function here, public void. Let's say function name is passage, and here also we'll declare four variables: int error, and then bool send, and then string message, and then t result. Now we'll store all these values in the variables declared above, and in send is equals to send, and then message is equals to message, and then result is equals to result. Now we'll be making the object for the class which we have made, the response class. this will be of record type. Record is the table name, and let's say the object name is rest, and here new. After that, the values, the table which the services class is returning, we store in the object of record type. After that, we'll be checking if obj is not is equals to null, then we'll write resp dot passage. We'll pass the values, error will be 0, and the send message will be true, boolean which we have declared, and the message, let's say congrats. Now, and the result will be obj. After that, in the else part, we'll write resp dot passage. We'll pass the values for those four variables. Error will be 1, and this will be false. And the message, let's say user doesn't exist, and the result will be null. And we'll return resp from here. As resp is of record, response of record type, so we have to change the data type from here also. So we write here response and record. So this is how we can create the API. And one more thing which we have left, we have to declare here that this is of get type of API or something else, get post. So this is the get API. So we write here get, and we save it. And if I'll run this, there are some errors. Okay, let's check. Okay, we have to declare this here, which where we are declaring the function. After that, we'll save this. And now if we hit the URL by appending this URL, the values which will be saved in the database according to that name will be retrieved. So this is how you can create the API for your database and Windows Store application connectivity. I hope you like this part of coding. For more updates, stay tuned to IntelliLearn.in. Thank you.